Many of the things that I love are not necessarily new, but that doesn't mean that we can't talk about them. So this is Throwback Review, the Throwback Thursday for all the things that I love. Simbarum is the tabletop RPG creation of the Swedish publisher Free League, most notably the same company that put out the Tales from the Loop RPG and also Mutant Year Zero. Set in the mystical land of Ambria, the game is centered around the ancient forest of Davakar. Davakar was once the realm and seat of the occultic empire of Simbar, which has since fallen into ruin thousands of years ago. The forest is dotted by ancient crypts and old ruins filled with powerful artifacts, which draw all but the greediest of brigands and grave robbers and, well, also your character. First and foremost, this game is absolutely oozing style and atmosphere, and it's pulled together nicely by the amazing lore and art. The game rests very heavily but comfortably on this content, at least for me. The game is shaped more directly in tone by the amazing artwork of Martin Gripp. Really, one look at the design and the aesthetic says it all. The visceral yet matte motion of his art captures the bleak and sometimes ethereal ecosystem of the game. One can't help but draw comparisons to Dark Souls, but it definitely has its own unique and powerful feel to it at the same time. Mechanically, the game approaches play similar to many other tabletops, with some important and actually very self-aware twists. Although utilizing the familiar D20 dice for many of the rolls, the game expresses itself in a slightly more nuanced fashion than 5th edition. It's just familiar enough to let you get your hands on the system before introducing slightly more expansive rules about how the dice work. The design certainly intends to make the play feel smooth and very cleverly keeps the rules from stomping on your toes when it comes to the flow of play. With a modular character design, it allows you to really expand what your character is and, frankly, can become. Although you could technically boil the game down to wizard, fighter, thief, it's actually really more than that. The game centers around archetypes as opposed to a specific class lane. If you know that you want to go melee, there's many options for melee. If you know that you want to go down the mystical arcane route, there's many options for that. Depending on how you level yourself and invest experience points into abilities, you can bring a lot of nuance and minor detail to your character that you would not get in a game like 5th edition. Interestingly, in playing Simbarum with friends, I found that backstory actually decided just as much of the mechanical aspects of a character as a quick read through the skill trees did. So much of how you want to be seen and understood in the game can be expressed through how you spec, which is an idea that games like Edge of the Empire have also explored. Simbarum at its heart is a game of magic, esoteric knowledge, all the while hosted by this sense of looming darkness behind the scenes. Using magic in Simbarum is incredibly dangerous and actually can cause just as much harm to the player as it can to your enemies. As much as you can crush your foes with it, it can crush you too, and overusing magic can cause you to become corrupted. In fact, corruption is a huge theme throughout Simbarum, and in fact, if you use magic too much and become too corrupted, you can actually transform into a terrible beast fueled by rage and inner turmoil. I have much of the game material in the way of the core book, Advanced Player's Guide, and the campaign books. I've yet to be disappointed by the game or content that is being written for it. In fact, they've done so much with such a honed world setting that I'd almost be overwhelmed by additional supplements at this point. There is plenty to work with in the core rulebook alone. The creators of Simbarum have certainly served up a generous helping of content, and I can get the sense they really do care about providing for the player. I can highly recommend Simbarum for anyone that wants to take a slightly smokier approach to the sort of tavern-soaked dungeon crawl that most RPGs can be. Like any role-playing game that's set in a fantasy world, you have a lot of the same trappings, but this is different. In fact, there's a much darker and more unique take on a lot of the things that we take for granted, for instance. I could blather on about all the things that I love about Simbarum, but actually, you really just should check it out for yourself. In fact, they've got a lot of their content on drivethroughrpg.com, and in fact, as of filming this video, you can actually go and get the core rulebook for $12.49 in PDF format. I've linked all the necessaries below, so if you want to check that out, you just go down below and click a couple links. I would also recommend looking through YouTube. YouTube has a lot of reviews that are a little more technical, do much of a deeper dive, get into the slightly crunchier aspects of the game. If that sounds like you, just type in Simbaroom and you'll be good to go. Well, there is another one of my faves for the archive. If you liked what you saw, go ahead and click the subscribe button below. That just tells me that you like what you're seeing and you want me to create more of it. And if you're more into video games these days, or you're just not a tabletop person, I also stream on Twitch. You can find me at twitch.tv/Cassadari. I stream every Tuesday for my Terrified Tuesdays group play of a horror survival game of some kind. They're really, really fun, and I'm joined by two very dear friends who are hilarious. And then lastly, if you want to keep in touch through social media, you can find me at Cassadari Games on Twitter and Instagram. I don't post as much there, but I do use it to update people about what I'm getting up to. So until the next one, we'll see you soon, and happy gaming.